part two of our 20-minute HIIT class followed by yoga. Probably plan to do about 30 to 35 minutes. A little bit of flowing, lots of stretching. Most importantly, a lot of breathing. So let's come to the front edge of your mat, if you have a mat. And take your palms together in front of your heart and close your eyes. You're going to take 5 or 6 deep breaths through the nose. Full inhale. Slow exhale. Observe the soles of your feet here and how the weight is shifting between the left and the right side of the body. Try to slightly tuck the tailbone between the legs. Open the heart. Tuck the shoulder blades towards one another and down. Navel anchored towards your spine. One more breath. Release the arms. Take the legs just a little bit wider. We're going to be spinning through the torso, bending the knees as we go. And just letting the arms fly. You can keep moving a little faster here, or just keep it nice and easy. Let's come back and bring the feet just a little closer than hip width apart. Inhale the arms up. Exhale, left hand down, right arm up, and maybe over if you want to. Take a look up at the ceiling, just past your tricep. Try to keep the shoulders and chest very open here, so we don't want to fold forward. Let's stack the shoulders right above the hips. Big inhale. Exhale, return to center. Same thing, other side. Inhale, right arm slides down, left arm up and over if you want to, creating a lot of length through the side body, both sides actually. We don't want to feel compression at all. So if you're feeling a little closed in right here, a little crowded in that space, take your reach more upward and less over. A little bit of compression here is fine as long as you're still breathing comfortably. One more breath. Exhale, float the knee down. Easy, mindful neck stretch here. Just drop right ear towards the right shoulder. Breathing deeply, not just in the lungs, but throughout the whole body. So I want to feel the back ribs expanding. Creating a little bit more length in your body, a little more space with that inhale. Exhale, take it the other way. Slow inhales. Slow and complete exhale. Come into a little bit of a forward bend flow. You can stay facing forward in front of your mat. You're just going to turn sideways. Inhaling, arms up. Take a look up. Exhale, dive forward. Arms sweep to the outside. Chest leads. And keep the knees bent here. If this is a little bit tight in your low back, bend your knees a lot now. And we're going to reverse that dive to come back up to standing. Exhale, palms to your heart. Inhale, reach it up. Exhale, dive forward. Inhale, reverse, same thing. Exhale, prayer hands. One more time, inhale, lift the arms. Exhale, dive. This time, stay here. And breathe in your forward bend.
If you want more sensation, you can take the hands behind the legs and gently draw the chest closer. Down to the floor, palms flat, and step back into your plank pose. Inhale in plank, or knee plank. Exhale, lower in chaturanga, or bring your knees down. Inhale, upward dog or cobra. Exhale, downward dog. Again, inhaling, plank or knee plank. Exhale, lower down, keep the belly strong. Inhale, upward dog or cobra. Exhale, downward dog. Let's turn down dog, let's pedal the feet a little bit. Then settle into your downward facing dog. Lifting the crease between your legs and your seat, up and back. So a lot of length through the back here, sinking the heels down where they don't have to touch. And then let's take the right leg up. Bend the knee. Roll the right hip on top of the left hip and just let that leg relax behind you. Now let's be more active in this leg. We're going to lift the knee just a little bit higher and flex the leg so that the heel is driving towards the seat. One more breath. Exhale, right foot back down. Inhale the left leg up. Bend the knee, roll the hip. Squeeze the heel closer to your seat, lift the left knee a little higher. And then exhale, release back to down, facing down. One more time, right leg comes up. This time, exhale and step the right foot forward towards the hands. Drop the back heel, left arm reaches forward, up and back to find warrior two. Right knee's bent, left leg is straight. Open your chest towards the hip, the long side of your mat. Take your gaze over the right fingertips. Let's inhale to reverse warrior, soften the left arm down and open the right side. And exhale to warrior two. Inhale, reverse. Exhale, warrior two. Take a look at warrior two. Look down at your right knee. Make sure that you can see your big toe. If your knee is pressing forward, open that right leg just a little bit more so that the knee is tracking out towards the little toe side of your foot. Belly strong. Big inhale. Good. Exhale, soften the arms. Parallel the feet. We're going to turn to the other side of the mat for warrior two. And the left leg. Inhale, soften the right arm. Open up the left side, reverse warrior. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse. Exhale, warrior two. Holding here, again, taking a look at that left knee, making sure you can see the toe. Make your adjustments. Pull really strong through the outside edge of that right foot here. Open the chest. Relax. Arms parallel feet. Take the hands to the hip bones, fingers to the hip points. On an inhale, lift the chest upward. Then exhale, dive forward.
Once you're forward here, just let the arms relax. Let your head dangle.
You might try walking your hands a little further forward and pressing back from the hips and the seat. And then let's take the left hand down just under the face. And open up the right arm either to shoulder height or twist a little deeper, keeping the low back flat. So we're only twisting through the upper body, the chest and shoulders. Get really broad through the back, the upper back. One more breath. Exhale, release. Same thing, other side. Take your time. Relax back to center. We're going to wiggle the feet back together, heel toe the feet till they're about hips width apart. Bend the knees just a tiny bit. And then just let your upper body hang as you roll it very slowly. Let the head be the last thing to come upright. And once you're up, you can roll the shoulders up and back. Just a little bit of balance. So let's start with tree pose. We're going to bring the weight mostly into the right leg. So spread the toes out. Keep the knee just slightly bent. And for now, place the left heel on the inside of the right ankle. Think about where you'd like your arms here. So we could bring the palms together in prayer. You could open your arms out to about shoulder height, opening the chest. Or maybe as you get settled into tree pose, you might try bringing the arms overhead. So as we come into this balance, we want to avoid pressing on the knee with this left foot. Find something to keep your head and eyes steady on, and don't move the head from side to side. Keep your gaze somewhat relaxed. And then if you feel ready, and when you feel ready, bring the left foot a little higher. If you wobble, it's okay. If you have to come out of the pose and get back into it, that's okay too. Keep that right knee slightly bent. Breathe deeply. Zip up the side body. Pulling the front belly into your back to support this balance. Two more breaths. Relax. Maybe take that right leg and just move it around a little bit. Circle the ankle. With the weight mostly in the left leg, bend the knee slightly. Take the right heel to the inside of the left ankle. Bring your arms to your preferred location. Set your gaze. Focus on your breathing. You can come up higher if you want to. last breath here. Okay, let's step back to the front of your mat if you're not already there. And we're going to inhale, arms up once again. Exhale, dive forward.
Inhale to lift halfway up and lengthen your spine.
Exhale, fold.
Inhale, come to plank.
Exhale, lower down, crocodile or chaturanga.
Inhale, upward dog or cobra.
Exhale, downward dog.
Let's lift the right heel on an inhale.
Exhale, step the right foot forward. Drop the left knee. We're going to take the hands to the inside of that right foot and take the left knee back a few inches. So the inside of the right knee is hugging the right shoulder or upper arm. We're going to get active there. Squeeze the right leg towards that right arm. Press into the top of the left foot. Option to stay here, or we're going to add a twist. So if you like this and this is feeling nice, practice here or come down even a little lower. And lizard. Otherwise, we're going to keep the left hand down, open up the right side, you can stay here, or you can come up with the left knee, come to the outside edge of the left foot and the right foot, gently twist, center, bring the left knee to the floor, shift the hips back, and we're going to sit back on the heel if that's comfortable for you. Straighten the right leg in front and fold forward. If it doesn't work to sit back on your left heel, just stay up on the left knee, straighten the right leg forward and fold there. Deepen your breath just a little more. One more breath. Rise up. Take the hands on either side of the foot. Step the right leg back and up for down dog split.
Open the hip. Legs up. Heel come towards your seat.
Step the right leg forward again. Keep the left heel up, and we're coming into high lunge. Big inhale. Exhale, twisting, bringing the hands together. Left elbow is going to come down to the right thigh. Press into the hands. Open the chest. Breath. Exhale, hands down. Step back, downward facing dog.
Inhale, plank
or knee plank. Exhale, lower down. So the top of the arms are parallel to the floor. Inhale, open up your chest. Full breath or up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog.
Inhale, left leg high.
Exhale, step it forward. Lower the right knee. Bring the hands to the inside of the left foot. Again, we're going to press the left leg towards the left arm. And also at the same time, engaging the top of the right foot towards your mat. Pressing firmly. Your breath. option to stay here. Move a little lower onto your forearms or come into the twist. If you're twisting, right hand stays down. Left arm opens. And again, an option to come onto the outside edges of both feet. One last breath here. And exhale the left arm down. Right knee down. Shift the hips back. Sit on the heel, fold forward over that left leg. Exhale, come back. Hands to either side of the left foot. On your inhale, we're going to step it back to down dog split. The left leg's going to come up. And exhale, step it forward. Right heel stays up off the mat. We're coming into our high lunge. Big inhale here. Exhale, palms in front of your heart. Twisting. Press into the hands to revolve the chest just a little bit more. One more breath. Exhale, hands down either side of the foot. Inhale, back to plank. Exhale, lower down. Hovering, elbows really close to the body. Inhale, either lower all the way down and open the chest up for cobra, shoulders down and breath back. And then exhale, child's pose. We'll be breathing here for a few moments. Take one more breath in child's pose. And then make your way to downward facing dog one more time. We'll come down onto knees. And then onto your seat. I'm going to take the legs straight in front of you. Lift the flesh away from the bones so you can feel a nice solid base for your seat. And then on an inhale, let's take the arms up. And exhale, reach forward a few inches, chest towards the toes. Inhale, lift it back up, get really long through your back. Sit down into your seat. And exhale, forward fold just a little bit further. Chest towards the toes. Inhale up. Exhale, same thing, chest towards the toes a little further. And then this next time on your exhale, bring the chest towards the toes as far as we can. So your body's natural stopping point comes to you. And then let the hands rest. Bow the head. And take your hands anywhere. On your legs, on the floor, behind your feet. two more breaths like this. Nice side opening here, so take it easy with this one. If it gets uncomfortable, come back to the seated position. Try again, let your breath move you further. Slide the right arm down to the inside of the right leg, and inhale the left arm high. And stay open and fairly upright here. So in other words, if you find yourself folding forward in order to reach towards your toe, come back here, and don't worry about touching the toe. Two more breaths. Exhale the left arm up and down. Same thing other side, slide the left arm along the inside of the left thigh, and on your inhale, take the right arm up. Keep the chest open, the back is broad. And exhale, you can take the arm a little further, if that's okay. Use your breath to expand your body. Use the exhale to sink just a little deeper, even if it's not a physical movement, just a mental shift. Moving into your spaces. Last inhale here. Exhale, release. And then come down onto your back with your knees bent and your feet up. So to start, let's just take some little rocks left and right, sweeping the knees off to the side. You could try bringing your knees up towards your chest for the same motion, or maybe some little circles here. And then if it's comfortable for you to become totally reclined with arms and legs extended, let's do that now. Lift and shift the shoulders down your back. If lying flat on your back doesn't feel good for you, just come onto your side. Or you could keep your feet on the mat and bend your knees. Just enjoy the sensation of the effort and the work of your practice just floating away here. Let the body become very heavy, supported by the earth. Enjoy a lightness and a spaciousness in the front of the chest, through the ribcage. If you haven't done so already, close your eyes. Let the forehead smooth out. And just be here in this moment. Calm the mind. Bring peacefulness into your body. And celebrate a grateful and thankful feeling in your heart.
bring our awareness back to full breath. Take a long inhale through the nose. And exhale out of the mouth. Bring your right foot back to the mat. And then breathe. Same thing with the left leg. And then step the feet about as wide as the outside edges of your mat. So drop the knees off to the left and to the right. And back to the left. And to the right. And then let's take the knees up towards the chest. And imprint the lower back into your mat. Rolling onto your right side. Take a moment here and come back to an upright seated position when you're ready. Seated position, let's sit up nice and tall. Take an easy twist to the right and to the left. And take your hands onto the floor in front of you. Walk your fingertips forward. Bow your head.